All right, so No Matter What by Badfinger. This is off their No Dice album, recorded in 1970. And it's just another fantastic power pop song by them, one of their biggest. The other one, Baby Blue, of course, which I did a tutorial on that a couple of years ago. Two great songs, you know. They had another one, Day After Day, which is also just an awesome song. So good. This one was produced by, this album was produced by a guy called Mal Evans, which was an Apple guy, because Apple had signed them. Paul McCartney sort of led the charge in getting these guys signed. In fact, when they did that song, Come and Get It, that was actually Paul McCartney's song. And there are some people that actually think this song is Paul McCartney's, right? Because it's so McCartney. There's so much McCartney in this song. It's crazy. Anyways, I could go on and on about the history of this band and Apple Records and everything else, but I won't. But if you go to my website and click that link there, and or in the description box below, you know, I always have a page on my website where I do a little write-up and stuff of these songs, right? So be sure to check that out. Anyway, so we're in the key of A here, and there's basically two guitars, and it's not a really complicated song. And to me, the hook of the song is, despite all the strong melodic stuff going on, the hook of the song is when that guitar comes in. With the Leslie speaker, right? It's just such a hook for me. You know, I remember when this song came out, I would just listen and listen until that part, because that just was so good, right? Okay, so we're in A, and the first guitar is going to start it like this. All right, so all that is just an A chord, two downstrokes, then do an upstroke on your G string, and hammer on D 2-4, back to the G. Just an upstring on that, or upstroke on that. On the A note and the G string. All right, and then the song starts, and we're just going to continue that. But when we go up to the next chord, which is B minor, we don't need to do the whole that. We're just going to go, right? Just that hammer, and then we make the change. All right, so it's going to sound like this. Right, then we B minor, right, and it's the same thing, so it's, and just end on that hammer, right, and then we've got D, E, right, A, A, E. Then we've got the next verse. That's the fill that this guitar does, right? And that's just an arpeggio where you're going just down, right? A and D string. Just B, G, B, G, D, right? And then we get into the bridge. And the bridge chords are F sharp minor, right? Or you could do F sharp minor 7. And then we got a B 7. And then we've got an E7. And then we got an A7. And then we've got a D7. So they're all seventh chords so far. And then we've got a B minor, which actually takes us back to the key of A, because we've changed keys a few times here. And this is just really good songwriting. And all this guitar does is it just goes, just slashing. And then this again. Mm-hmm. right? And that's how we end it. We're just like on a G chord here. We don't need that there, just muting out the A string. Right, that's what we're focusing on there, to the E, right? Okay, and then we're heading into the chorus, which is just like a verse. All right, so, and this guitar, it just, from here on, it repeats what I've showed you so far. And then the other guitar is just doing slashes, right? So it's, no matter what you do, right? So just A, B. You could do the A here if you wanted, or here. B minor, and then D, E, B, E, A, E, right? Boom, da, do, da, do. And then heading to the bridge, he's going to do this like. But what you want to do is you want to bounce that off that open A, right? So you want to hold that A chord. All right, and then we're into the bridge. And this guitar is going to be like. Just kind of strumming those chords with 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 as the focus, right, of the rhythm. And then when we get to the A, we're going to do this. It's a little bit different than the first one, which was. Right, this one is. Right, but the big Leslie guitar has not come in yet, right? They're sort of saving that, right, for the chorus. And then we do it again. Right, and then we're into the chorus. But before we get to the chorus, I just wanted to point out, this bridge is so, it's so Beatles, you know, it's so McCartney. And because it's got that descending thing going on in that F sharp minor 7, right? You can do it up here. I'm just gonna do it up here just to demonstrate how cool the descending thing is. And we've got that note there, that's the 7th, right? And then we go to B7, right? So we've come from there to there. And then we've got E7, go there, right? To A7, and we got there, and then D7, we got that, right? And B minor, got that there, and then back to A. So that note is. Which is just so cool. I mean, this is one of the things that, to me, makes the Beatles and, well, the Beatle-type writers so good, right? Because there's always this sort of underlying intelligence going on in the music that you might not even be aware of it until you start looking at it, right? And then you go, oh, yeah, well, that's a real clever sort of hook. Okay, so if you just listen for that note. So then we're heading into the chorus, right? So now the big guitar comes in. What that is, it's really not complicated. It's just. And you can just bounce that off that open A string, right, just to fill in. And then we'd go to the B minor, but I do kind of a B minor 7, because I need that little finger, right? So it's, while we're holding. and then just, it's just a D chord, up to the third and the fifth, 1, 3, 5, to E, 1, 3, 5, 1, that we slide it. Right then. And that leads into the, slide solo, right? Which is just, bridge again. And of course, the big Leslie guitar is. And through the bridge, you know, the Leslie guitar is going way down in the mix, right? Just arpeggiating those chords. And then they pump it up for this. Right? Because that's so catchy, right? Okay, and then we're pretty well getting to the end of it. Those are really all the parts. They just repeat now, right? So that last chorus is just going to be like, that sort of false ending. So that was kind of a combination of a couple of the guitar parts. But the actual, you know, Leslie part would be. And this. And that's it. The only thing I missed was. And that part there, at one point, that Leslie guitar does that little fill there, right? So it's just on the G, sliding up to the B, and then to the D on A5. Right? Just, what is that, 7, 9? To 7 on the D. So it would be like, anyways, that's it for this one. I hope you get something out of this. Hope you enjoy playing this song. And I had a really good time working on this because it's just, I'm a sucker for, the power pop stuff, right? Just so good. Anyways, like I said, I hope you get something out of it. I hope you enjoy playing the song, and we'll talk to you next time.